A very good morning, students. Today's topic is media advocacy. So first we need to understand what are different advocacy groups. A number of advocacy groups have emerged at global and national level to defend the rights of victims. International as well as national level has seen the emergence of various groups who are working for the rights of the people who are facing certain kind of violations, who are the victims, and they are trying to defend them through their actions. So these people are known as advocacy groups, or the other name is human rights defender. The primary aim is to help the victims of violation of human rights by sharing their miseries and fighting with the agencies of state with them and for them. So what these advocacy groups do, they try to help the victims of violation of rights. How do they do that? How do they help them? Firstly, by sharing their miseries, by sharing their problems and fighting with them and for them with the agencies who are responsible for that particular violation. Many a times the agencies of the state question their legitimacy, character and role. But in this situation, there are various problems which these advocacy groups face. And one major such problem which they face is that the government organizations or different agencies, they question their legitimacy, means they question their legal status. What is their character? What is their role in the fight of human rights for those people or for those groups? So to extend legitimacy to the advocacy groups, UN adopted a declaration in 1999. So only to help such advocacy groups, UN declared to extend the legitimacy of these advocacy groups. We'll see what that declaration was related to. Everyone has the right individually and in association with others to promote and to strive for the protection and realization of human rights and fundamental freedoms at the national and international level. So the first point which that declaration says, that everybody on this whole earth has a right, whether individually or whether in a group, to promote and to strive. Strive means to work for the protection and realization of human rights and the fundamental freedoms which are given to us being a human being, either at the international level or at the national level. In 2000, UN created a post of Special Representative of UN Secretary General on Human Rights Defenders to protect the rights of advocates. And for this purpose, they made a separate designation, a position, a post where a special representative will work for the human rights of these defenders, these advocators. Then in 2008, this post was replaced by UN Special Rapporteur on Human Rights Defender. The name, the designation was changed to UN Special Rapporteur on Human Rights Defender. The protective mechanism for defender was suggested internationally. And what was that? They requested that the states, means governments, should prevent intimidating acts against the defenders, that the government should not intimidate with the advocates or the defenders, as they are doing a good job. They are supporting the people who are the victims. So they must be supported, not questioned. Then requesting states to adopt specific mechanism to prevent such abuses. And UN also requested the governments of different nations that they should make a mechanism to prevent these kind of abuses, these kind of problems, or these kind of activities which create a problem for defenders or advocates. This was all about the efforts of UN for the human rights defenders. Now there are various advocacy groups. These are lawyers, then educational institutions, they create awareness. Then the corporate sector, as a CSR, corporate social responsibility, they do various tasks which are related with the help of the victims. Then NGOs, various non-governmental organizations, and finally media. Obviously, media is the strongest player in this because they bring about the events, the incidents, their miseries, the cases of human rights violation in front of public, and they pressurize the government also to take steps for the remedy of these people. So we will discuss media advocacy, as this is the major player in various advocacy groups. So media is the medium of mass communication, we all know, and it includes various types of media, that is print media, audio broadcasting like radio, audio visual broadcasting like television, and social media like Twitter, Facebook, and all that. Now the functions or roles of media in the defending the human rights. They provide publicity to the cases of violation of human rights. They bring it in front of the public about the details of various cases of human rights violation. Then it gives publicity to organizations and individuals involved in promotion of human rights education. Whomsoever organizations and individuals, NGOs are working for the promotion of human rights education, they give publicity to them, and they bring their names in front of the public so they can also utilize their services. Then media also help in educating people through various awareness campaigns. They suggest the ways and means to address the violation. They many times print such articles or present such talk shows in which there are various methods, there are various means which are told to the people about addressing the violations of human rights. Then they bring experts from all over the world, as I said in the talk shows. In those talk shows, they bring experts from all over the world in the field of human rights, and they talk about certain human right issues through their live discussions, and they provide the ways to oppose the violation in realization of human rights. They tell the masses that how they can themselves ensure that their rights are not violated. Then media also helps in assembling people and bringing the victims and perpetrators who have committed a crime to justice. Many times when they come to know about various violations, so they assemble people also so that the justice could be given to people who have suffered because of human rights violation, and whomsoever has committed the crime should be punished by the law system. Then is the next point is about guide the state and public in realization of human rights. They also help suggest government and the public also about the better ways of realizing their human rights. Then they provide information about significant schemes, policies of government, political parties, and leading judgments of the courts to the public so that they should be aware about the latest information, latest updates about human rights, their laws, and their other measures the government has taken for protection of human rights. Then initiative taken by media include construction of houses and school. Many a times due to corporate social responsibility, various media houses have constructed schools and houses for the poor people. They educate masses through their awareness campaigns. They help people by liberal collection of donation in emergency. Many a times they establish emergency relief funds, and in those funds people deposit money and they provide that money for that emergency. Then they help in expression and dissemination of news and views to public. Whatever information they get, they disseminate it to the public. They also collect the views of public and present others so that they can know about the viewpoints of different people who are involved in that particular scenario. Then finally, they act as a watchdog to prevent violation of human rights, as the people who commit such kind of crime, they also know that media is there. So media act as a role of watchdog, because people sometimes are afraid of media, that if this kind of thing will be known by the media, they could be exposed in front of the public. So in this way, various roles are played by media for the benefit of the public. Now the thing which is very important for media is self-regulation, because if media is fair, if media is unbiased, no doubt this is a blessing for a nation. But if it is not unbiased, if it is not fair, in that case it could create a lot of problems. So self-regulation is highly required for the media people so that they can control and they can present a unbiased view in front of public. To ensure appropriate use of powers, because media has a great power, they can change the viewpoint, they can bring about the facts to the public, so they have great power in their hands. So the media has certain responsibilities also with that power. That is, adopt a self-regulatory mechanism to present the truth to help victim of human rights to seek justice. Whatever true information they get, it is their responsibility that they should present that true information in front of public, and they should not be influenced by any powerful position. So they have to be self-regulatory in that particular thing. Then second is, take care of content and language of the report. Whatever report they are presenting, the content should be and the language should be decent enough, and it should not hurt the sentiments of any of the individual or group in the society. The language should be decent. Employ only well-qualified and trained reporters, because if the reporters are qualified, if they are trained, obviously they understand the ethics, they understand their responsibility, they understand the power they have, and they will use it very diligently so that they can do quality work. Then finally, exercise some control in publishing materials, reports or photos that create tension or sensitivity among various sections of society. So whenever there is such kind of reports or information or some material or maybe photos that they know could create attention or is very sensitive for various sections of the society, that material should be handled very carefully, and the information should be presented publicly through a very scrutinized way. So this is how they can self-regulate their operations, so that they can present a fair view in front of the public. So that's it for today. We'll discuss next about media advocacy in the next video. Till then, have a nice day.